تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب، ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب. الله سبحانه وتعالى He taught our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that his da'wah, inviting people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will go through different stages. So the first stage, it was confidential. They used to meet at the house of Al-Arqam ibn Abi Al-Arqam, one of the Sahaba who was 17 years old. Those young people, Islam was brought on their shoulders. For those young people out there, Al-Arqam ibn Abi Al-Arqam was 17 years old. He was a champion. Be like him, inshallah. So they used to meet there confidentially, and the Prophet ﷺ would teach them, you know, Islam and whatever was revealed of the Quran. Until one day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet ﷺ, وَأَنذِرْ عَشِيرَتِكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, meaning, start giving da'wah to your close relatives, to your family members. And the Prophet ﷺ did this. Then, the third stage of da'wah was, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, make it public. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ, proclaim your invitation, make it public, talk to everyone. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, and turn away from those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet ﷺ went to the highest mountain in Mecca, which is the mountain of As-Safa. And he started saying, Wa Subhan, and this is the cry of war, to warn people that there's something serious happening. So all the big shots of Mecca, they ran to the source of the voice, and they found the Prophet ﷺ on the top of the mountain. And the first one to be there was none other than Abdul Uzza ibn Abdul Muttalib. I know that you don't know who is this man, but you only know him by Abu Lahab, but this is his real name. That was the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ and his first next door neighbor. So they asked the Prophet ﷺ, why are you gathering us here? And the Prophet ﷺ said to them, if I were to tell you that there is an army coming to attack you behind this valley, would you believe me? And they said, of course, yes. He said, why? And they said, you have lived with us for 40 years and you have never lied. Then he said, I am the messenger of Allah. Allah sent me with the Quran. So the first one to reject him was his own uncle, Abdul Uzza ibn Abdul Muttalib. And this is when he got that title, Abu Lahab, the father of the flame, or the one with the flame. So he said, Ali hada jama'tana? Is it for this silly reason you're gathering us? And then he waved with his right hand like this. He said, Tabban laka sa'ir al-yawm. May you perish by the end of today. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these ayat. Tabbat yada abi lahabin wa tab. Not only the right hand that waved in the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but the two hands will perish. What's the meaning of tab? And why did Allah say this? And did this really what happened to Abu Lahab? Did he end up dying? Really applying the meaning of tab? If you want to know the details, inshallah, wait for the next video. We're going to continue the story. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.